हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी चैप्टर नंबर 16 ऑफ क्लास 7th. एवरीवन, टू बी अ लेडी. सो एवरीवन, हियर देयर इज अ लेडी, ओके, हु वांट्स टू बी अ फ्लावर गर्ल. मीन्स अ शी इज अ गर्ल हु वांट्स टू बी अ मैनर्ड लेडी बिकॉज शी केम टू अ प्रोफेसर फॉर लर्निंग about the manner of everything. So everyone, in this story we are going to study about a lady who just faces her insult by the professor, and at last with the conditions of professor they got agreed on a mutual understanding, and professor agreed to make her learn about their etiquettes and manners to be a flower girl in the society. And everyone, this chapter, To Be a Lady, is an act adapted from the G.V. Shaw most popular play, Pygmalion. Shaw was a major critic of his time. He is sensitive towards his issues ailing in the British society. That's why for showing that, for perplexing them in their stories, he has written this story. So everyone, G.V. Shaw means George Bernard Shaw. He is a writer of this story which we are going to study now. So everyone, here characters of this story is the flower girl. The lady who want to be a flower girl, her name is Lisa. Okay. And the professor to whom she comes, his name is Higgins. Okay. And everyone, there are two more characters are there. First, third is Pricking. So everyone, this person is colleague of Higgins. Okay. And Mrs. Purse, she is the housekeeper of Professor Higgins. So everyone, there are only four characters: Higgins, Mrs. Purse, Lisa, and Mrs. Prickings. Now everyone, we are going to start. Higgins laboratory in Wimpole Street. Mrs. Purse enters looking perplexed. Mrs. Purse, a young woman want to see you, sir. Higgins, a young woman, what does she want? So everyone, Higgins was in his laboratory, means in his office, and same time his maid Mrs. Purse come inside and she was looking confused, and so she said to Higgins that, sir, there is a woman on the door and she wants to meet you. So Higgins said that, what does she want? Mrs. Purse, well, sir, she says you will be glad to see her when you will know what she has come about. She is quite a common girl, sir, very common indeed. I should have sent her away, only I thought perhaps you wanted her to talk into your machines. I hope you have not done wrong. Really, you see such queer people sometime. You will excuse me, I am sure, sir. So everyone, here Mrs. Purse said, well, sir, you will be very glad to meet that girl, and means I think so she is very common girl, means very common, because I don't think that I have seen her before in your office. So I have not said anything to her. I just thought that you will talk to her in your own way, into your machines, everyone, means into your own way. So I think I have not done wrong. Higgins, oh, that's right, Mrs. Purse. Has she an interesting accent? So everyone, here Higgins asked to Mrs. Purse that, okay, you have not done any wrong, means whatever you did, that was correct. Now just tell me, means what the way of speaking, means in which accent she is speaking. Accent, everyone, way of speaking. So here is a teacher. Higgins is a professor, everyone, about the accent, who teaches others about the accent and make them learn properly about the essence of any language. Mrs. Purse, oh, something dreadful. Sir, really, I don't know how you can take an interest in it. So Mrs. Purse said, no, sir, means really that was so bad, I cannot describe it, that, but I am sure that you will not surely not take interest in that. Against two prickies. Let's have her up. Show her up, Mrs. Fuzz. She rushes across to his working table, pick out a cylinder to use the phonograph. Phonograph, everyone, is record player. So everyone, Higgins just got curious. He said, okay, there is no harm to meet her, so let her come upstairs. So he was saying to his colleague that, okay, I will meet him and I will come to find out that how like lady she is. So Mrs. Fuzz only half resigned to it. Very well, sir, it's for you to say. She goes downstairs. So okay, she said, okay, I'll go downstairs and I will call her. Higgins, this is a rather a bit of luck. I'll show you how I make record. You will set her talking. I will set it down in the bells, visible speech, then in broad roaming, and then we will get her on the phonograph, so you can turn her on the often you like with the written transcript before you. So Higgins said, okay. He means Higgins, actually everyone, he was talking to his colleague and he was saying, when this lady will come here, so I will keep this record player on and then we will start recording her voice. Because everyone, Higgins was a professor of accent, so he just take interest the way of speaking the people how speaks. So he said, we will just see how this lady speaks, and if she speaks in a very interesting way, so surely we will record that, and whenever we want to listen that, we will listen. So Mrs. Purse returned, this is young woman, sir. So meanwhile, everyone, when Higgins was talking to Pickering, to his colleague, so he said, same time in this conversation, meanwhile of that, Mrs. Purse come upstairs and she said, sir, this is here young woman. The flower girl enters in a stage. She has a hat with three ostrich feather, orange, blue, sky red. She has a nearly open apron and shoddy coat has been tidied a little. So everyone, a young girl means a flower girl. Lisa was the name of that girl, and everyone, she was known as flower girl because she sells flower in her shop. Okay, and when she entered, she was in that appearance that she was putting a hat in that three ostrich feather were there, which was of various color like orange, blue, sky, red, and means which apron she was putting on that was so gaudy. Shoddy means everyone, so means badly made. And means by his first appearance, by her first appearance only, Mrs. Higgins was just did not take interest in that girl. Because everyone, first impression is last impression, as we all know. So Higgins, by her first appearance only, did not show any interest on her. Higgins, so shoddy and repulsive, be off with you. We don't want to you here. So Higgins, everyone, did not just talk also. He did not want to talk to that girl by her first appearance. Means he said, as he saw the girl, he said, you just go off from here. We don't want to meet you. You are so gaudy and repulsive. We don't want to see you. Don't say you be so saucy. You aren't heard what I came yet. To Mrs. Purse, who is waiting at the door, a further instruction. Did you tell him? I come in a taxi. So everyone, flower girl just said to Higgins, why you are becoming so repulsive? Means even you have not listened that for what I came. You are just giving your decision that you don't want to see me. So lady, flower girl said to Mrs. Purse that you have not told to him that what I have came. You have not given him instruction that as I told you, and that you have not told him that I come with in a taxi. So Mrs. Purse said, nonsense girl. Do you think a gentleman like Mr. Higgins care for what you came in? So everyone, actually that girl was completely means so gaudy. Means she just believe in her show off. Okay, so that's why she was saying that she come in taxi. So Mrs. Purse said at the same time of that, you silly girl, you really believe that person like Mr. Higgins will care about by which you came? So flower girl said, oh, we are proud. He aren't about giving a lesson, not him. L, I aren't come here to ask her any compliment. If any money not good enough, I can go elsewhere. So everyone here, flower girl said, oh, It means he is so proud on his talent. Means if he doesn't want to give me a lesson, no problem. If he doesn't want money, no issue with that. I'll go anywhere else for teaching or for learning something. Higgins, good enough for what? So everyone, Higgins said, means actually he was talking about money. So he said, money means about good enough for what? Flower Girl said, good enough for you. Means the money good enough will be for you. Now you know, don't you? I have come to have lessons. I am, and to pay for I to make no mistake. So everyone, he said, Flower Girl said that good enough for you means I come to take lesson with you, but for that I will pay you and I will make no mistake. Higgins, recovering his breath with a gasp, he said, well, what do you expect me to say to you? Higgins said, now what do you want to me to say? Flower Girl, well, if you was a gentleman, you might make ask to sit down. I think, don't I tell you, I am bringing your business. So Flower Girl said, if you might ask me to sit down, I will think something, but I want you should teach me a lesson about the ascent. And you don't think that I had just come by bringing you business. Higgins said, picking, shall we ask this baggage to sit down or shall we throw her out of the window? So everyone, this was really height of insult for that girl. Means Higgins was asking to pick that baggage means luggage. So means he was considering that lady to with a baggage. He said, should be asked to this luggage to sit down or we should throw her out from the window. Flower Girl running away in the terror of piano, where she turned at once. Means everyone, as she listened, she started to move away from there. But meanwhile of that, she turned at once. Means, wounded and whimpering. So everyone, this means she really got extreme angry. Obviously, she will get, as she was just considering her with a luggage. And he was saying that he will throw out to her. So I won't be called a baggage when I have offered to pay like any lady. So everyone, that Flower Girl, she got angry and she said, I don't think that I should be considered with the luggage, as I have come to give you money for whatever you will teach me. Motionless, the two men stared at her from the other side of the room, amazed. So everyone, meanwhile of this, other colleagues of Higgins were also seeing to that lady in a very stern manner, means fixedly. Piscreen, gently, what is it you want, my girl? The Flower Girl, I want to be a lady in a flower shop instead of sailing at the corner of Tottenham Court Road, but they won't take me unless I can talk more gentle. I know he can teach me well here. I am ready to pay him, not asking any favor. He treats me as if I was dirt. So everyone, Flower Lady means it was, so you can say it was height of insult. Means Higgins was to his colleagues also, he was means insulting that girl in a so bad way. So Flower Girl said, I don't want anything. I just want to be a flower girl. And I just want to be a sale flower at the Tottenham Court Road. And they management of that flower shop is denying to me. Even till then, I cannot talk more gentle. So I came here for learning. And he is treating me like as if I am dirt. Mrs. Purse, how can you be such a foolish, ignorant girl as you think you can afford to pay Mr. Higgins? So Mrs. Purse just insulting me. There was all the person who was insulting to her. Mrs. Purse said, means how can you such a so foolish girl that you are thinking that you can pay to Mr. Higgins for your teaching? Higgins, to her girl, sit down. So Higgins said to that girl, sit down. Mrs. Purse, severely, sit down, girl, do as you are told. She placed a stray chair near the Hunter between the Higgins and Priscilla stand behind it, waiting for a girl to sit down. And everyone, Mrs. Purse also said, "Sit down, girl, as he is saying to you, you just follow that." And then meanwhile, this Higgins stood, and means he was just waiting when this girl will sit down and he will start conversing to that girl. Already he has insulted to that girl so much, but then also as girl was in the need that time for learning in a good accent so that she can work in the flower shop. So she tolerated all the insult which Higgins and his colleagues and his servant did. So everyone, remaining chapter I will explain you in the next video. Thank you.